Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, we are studying chapter human skeleton, and in that we are studying topic condyloid joints. Now if I talk about condyloid joints, they are present in the metacarpopharyngeal joints, or they are called as joints which smooth or glide in an order. Now what's this? Let's study and find out today. Condyloid joints always allow biaxial movement, or I could say that being present in the elliptical cavity, they allow side-by-side movement. Yes, of course, they are a type of synovial joint along with your hinge joint, condyloid joints, your ball and socket joints, all are type of synovial joint. And being synovial joint, they will always have the presence of synovial fluid. Also, condyloid joints are majorly present in the radius and carpal region of your body. Condyloid joints. Now, condyloid joints can also be said as ellipsoid joints. Now, being oval-shaped condyle of one bone always fits into elliptical cavity of another bone. These joints basically allow biaxial movement. That biaxial movement means to and fro, or simply you say it backward and forward, or side to side. But they never allow rotation. That notation is always restricted in this kinds of joint. Now, example of condyloid joints would be your radius, carpal, or your metacarpopharyngeal joints. Now, students, this diagram purely depicts how condyloid joints would be working and how side-by-side movement occurs, and your ulna radius purely depicts the presence of condyloid joints in your hands, and whenever you do the movements of side by side picking or just moving it in a particular direction and not rotation, that's the point your condyloid joints come into action. I hope students, you all are very clear with this concept of condyloid joints. Thank you.